Why? Why, Billy? Why have you done? I'll tell you why, mate. The idea of me, a 64-year-old bloke, going for a drink with a gay man is not very radical in 2022, is it? Really? Let's be honest. It's kind of Ronald the Bloody Mill, isn't it? Why would you write a song about it? Clearly, gays and lesbians are still discriminated against, and if your Supreme Court gets its way, there'll be more discriminated against, so you have to get your ass in gear in November and sort that shit out for us. So, you can storm the Supreme Court, you know that, don't you? You are allowed to storm the Bastille or the Winter Palace or Fulham and Masons. You can storm those places if you want. You really am. I'm just mentioning it. It's an historical precedent. If you need it, it's a historical precedent.
Well, you can ask the British to come and burn it down.
Because we've done that once already. We'll do it again for you if you like. Just as a wide world. Open out. Open out. The Canadians might be. You might need us.
I digress. As they say in the Supreme Court. But, yeah. It's one of those situations where the gay and lesbian community have made huge advances, and it's absolutely clear that particularly the trans community are now in the front line and are the target of so much hatred as part of the culture wars. And it's kind of a really interesting thing happened when I was talking about it on tour. A young trans person tweeted that how great it was to hear Billy Bragg or just respond in the way we did to the idea of supporting the trans and non-binary community, how they felt seen to be in an audience like that. And this is the kicker, and this is not said in any kind of sarcastic way, in a very real way. They said how great it was to find that reaction in an audience that came of age in the 1980s. And that says something about how we have been able to get our priorities right now, but also how we're seen by young people. You know, how we're seeing, perhaps we're a little bit dated in our views, and there is a cohort in the Billy Bragg audience in England that had a little bit of trouble with the issue of trans rights. How could I describe them politely? I think the best way I could describe them would be to call them geezers of my age. And they tend to be the kind of geezer who comes to the gig in a Clash t-shirt. Comes to tell me all the things they did during the miners' strike and how radical they are, they're feminists and things like that. Those kind of guys who are rather resting on their radical laurels, having done not much really in the last 20 or 30 years. Those guys, love them, bless them. They were there in the day, they were there back in the day. And they did their bit, and more power to them for doing their bit. But, wake up, friends, Margaret Thatcher's dead. You know? At least we hope. Halloween coming, who knows? Things have moved on. Things have moved on, and the new generation that's come through addresses politics in a different way. It's not as ideological as it was when we were doing stuff in the 80s. And why would it be? The Berlin Wall's come down when you're in a more or less opposed to ideological society. And I think the key thing is, or to me, the interesting thing, is that the great political campaigns of the 21st century, Me Too, Black Lives Matter, Extinction Rebellion, they're not ideological, but what they have in common is they are accountability movements. They're seeking to hold those in power to account. And if, you know, although it's not ideological, if socialism isn't about holding the powerful to account, what is it about? You know, that's the antithesis to the divine right of kings, is accountability. That's what they fought the Civil War over. In my country, what they called the good old cause was ultimately accountability. No one is above the law. So they're not that far away. And from my friends who were on the miners' strike, it's not that hard to get your head around, because the things that certainly the Conservative government are saying when they seek to stigmatise, particularly the trans community, the things they say about the trans community are almost word for word what they said about gays and lesbians in the 70s and the 80s. Almost word for word. Same shit, different day. It's not that hard to get your head around, mate. So I've written this song that I want to play for you now that kind of encourages them to perhaps, I'll just put it as bluntly as I can without being rude. We're never going to be hip again, lads, all right? Stop. We ain't never going to be pretty again, are we? But with a little bit of forethought, perhaps stepping back for a moment and listening and trying to engage from where politics is now. If we can manage that, there's a chance that we can still be relevant. Mercy on us, Father, who bring through this age of storms. We barely have the time to bind the wounds caused by shattered norms. The credulous are on crusade against reality. Freedom's just another word for acting with impunity. It's hard to get your bearings in a world that doesn't care. Positions I took long ago feel comfy as a lone armchair. But the kids that tear the statues down, they challenge me to see the gap between the man I am and the man I wanna be. Same old pointless argument blew up again last night. The one where one of us is wrong, and both of us feel in the right. My indignation drove me to say things that I regret. But the one I love the most with my self-righteous temperament. Now I must face the consequence of the thoughtlessness I've shown. It wasn't my intention to spend this evening all alone. With wounded pride is all I have to keep me company. The gap between the man I am and the man I wanna be. I'm used to people listening to what I have to say. So I find it hard to think that it might help if I just stepped away and adjusted my perceptions to reflect reality. And the gap between the man I